A message to the church, the reasons why America must be judged. 1. The church in America is in need of repentance. There are many people who say that the church in America will experience a revival and that this country will become great again. They give evidence that Donald Trump is a man for the hour who is supposed to build up this country and restore it to greatness and wealth and influence on the world stage. But will this country really become great again? And can the church experience a revival without having true repentance first? A revival cannot come unless the church repents, and repentance cannot come until there is conviction of sin and a realization that one must be restored to close fellowship with God. Sin separates us from having close fellowship with God and it keeps our prayers from being answered. Revival can only come where there is true repentance from sin and recognition of how evil sin is. Revival will come to the church in America, but it will be in the form of persecution and distress. Through the distress and persecution that the church will face, many Christians will humble themselves and turn to God and repent from their unconfessed sin, which God is convicting them about. I have to repent from sin many times a day whenever I feel convicted of it. And each time I repent, God forgives me. He will do the same for anyone who turns to Him and repents. If we repent, God will forgive and God will restore us to close fellowship with Him. But we Christians need to feed ourselves from His Word so that our spirit will not be tempted with sin and so that our spirit's needs will be met. Jesus said in John chapter 6 verse 63 these profound words. 63. It is the Spirit that quickeneth, the flesh profiteth nothing. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. God's words are spirit and life. They are life to our spirit. The body, a physical entity, needs physical food. And the spirit, a spiritual entity, needs spiritual food. The food for our spirits is the Word of God, the Bible. In Matthew chapter 4 verse 4, Jesus said, But he answered and said, It is written, Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. 2. Why America must be judged. Sadly, America must be judged for all its wickedness and rebellion. It once brought the gospel to the nations and it once promoted God, but it has rejected God and has rejected the Bible and has rejected the Ten Commandments, God's eternal laws of moral living. And, sadly, the church has allowed sin into its midst and has embraced worldly things and has become lukewarm. We Christians need to consider the words of Jesus when he spoke to his disciples about how one cannot love both God and worldly things, mammon. In Matthew chapter 6 verse 24, Jesus said, No man can serve two masters. For either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. Ye cannot serve God and mammon. If we love the ways of the world, we cannot love God. If we serve our fleshly nature and refuse to seek God's will, we would not love God or be serving God. Not loving God is a scary thought. It means that we would love the world and would love God very little. Eventually, our love toward God would grow so cold that we would become like the church of Ephesus mentioned in Revelation chapter 2 verses 3 to 5. Revelation chapter 2 verses 3 to 5. 3. And hast borne, and hast patience, and for my name's sake hast labored, and hast not fainted. 4. Nevertheless I have somewhat against thee, because thou hast left thy first love. 5. Remember therefore from whence thou art fallen, and repent, and do the first works, or else I will come unto thee quickly, and will remove thy candlestick out of his place, except thou repent. For the Lord Jesus to remove thy candlestick means that he would be removing his light and life from a former Christian, and he would be spiritually dead, cut off from God. That is the case with people such as Judas Iscariot, who betrayed the Lord Jesus in order to have money. His love was more toward money than toward God. And even though Judas felt some remorse over his sin, he did not repent. Instead, he hung himself because he couldn't face the guilt of his sin, which he was unwilling to truly repent from. If he had repented, he would have been forgiven, and he would not have desired to commit suicide. When Judas became one of the 12 disciples, he was a believer in Jesus and a follower of Jesus. Jesus did not make any mistakes. He did not choose someone who never loved him. He chose a man who served and loved God. But Judas later became covetous and stole money. Money became his pursuit. And for the sake of having more money, Judas betrayed the Lord Jesus. Likewise, Christians can pursue their own goals and plans, or harden the hearts through sin, and by doing so would reject Jesus Christ. Such people may still speak as if they loved God. But God knows the hearts. Jesus spoke of such people in Matthew chapter 15 verse 8. 8 This people draweth nigh unto me with the mouth, and honoreth me with their lips, but the heart is far from me. When the people who were Christians turn from God toward idols, their evil influences will affect the non-Christians around them. The people who claim to be Christians will become more and more wicked in their hearts and actions, and the world will follow with them. That is the main reason why God will have to judge this country of America.